Sleeping pills help your brain relax and fall asleep. Do you know how sleeping pills relax your brain?
There are three main ways we can calm down our brain. Do you know these three? GABA, melatonin, orexin.
As you know, we can get GABA tablets from the pharmacy or from certain foods, and they help our brain relax. How do they do that? I'll explain soon. Second, we have melatonin. It's very famous, so you might know it. We can use it when we have trouble sleeping, like when we're traveling and can't sleep. Melatonin tells our brain it's time to go to bed. Third, there's orexin. Orexin keeps us awake and full of energy. So when we block it, it helps our brain to calm down and get ready for sleep.
Now, let's see how these three pathways are related to sleeping pills. Then, do you know the four types of sleeping pills that are commonly used today?
Benzodiazepines, non-benzodiazepines, melatonin receptor agonists, and orexin receptor antagonists are commonly used. Barbiturates were also frequently used in the past.
Very nice. The targets of these three are GABA receptors, this one targets melatonin receptors, and this one targets orexin receptors. The main sleeping pills currently in use target these three pathways. Let's do a quick quiz. Do you know how to calm down your brain?
There are three main ways we can calm down our brain. First, the GABA system helps our brain relax. Second, the melatonin system tells our brain it's time to go to bed. Third, the orexin system keeps us awake and full of energy, so when we block it, it helps our brain to calm down and get ready for sleep.
Very nice. Now, let's take a closer look at each of the medicines. GABA binds to the GABA receptor on the surface of nerve cells, causing something to happen, which in turn relaxes your brain. What exactly is happening? It said that there are currently GABA-A, GABA-B, and GABA-C receptors, and the sleeping pills target the GABA-A receptor. GABA binds to GABA-A receptors and helps your brain relax. Can you tell me what happens during this process?
GABA binds to its receptors and opens the gates, letting chloride ions flow in. This helps calm the cells down.
What does cell calm down mean?
Usually, the inside of nerve cells is negative and the outside is positive. When sodium ions, which are positive, flow into the cell, the inside becomes positive, making the cell excited. Now, what happens if negative ions flow in? The negative ions cancel out the positive charge inside the cell, so the cell calms down.
Here are medicines like benzodiazepines, non-benzodiazepines, and barbiturates that help GABA work better.
GABA binds to its receptors and opens the gates, letting chloride ions flow in.
They open the gates even more, letting in more calming ions. This makes our brain feel calm and helps us fall asleep. To explain a bit more in detail, barbiturates increase the duration of chloride channel opening. Let's remember it with barbiturates increase barbie duration. On the other hand, benzodiazepines increase the frequency of chloride channel opening. This is a point often asked in tests, so keep it in mind.
By the way, are there things we need to be careful about when using benzodiazepines as sleeping pills?
Great question. When using benzodiazepines, we need to pay attention to which receptors the medicine works on. There are two types of benzodiazepine receptors, omega-1 and omega-2. Omega-1 receptors are all over the brain and help with making us sleepy and relaxed. Omega-2 receptors are in the front part of the brain and the spinal cord, and they help with reducing anxiety, relaxing muscles, and stopping seizures.
Simply put, omega-1 receptors help you sleep, and omega-2 receptors help relax your muscles.
So, if a medicine works more on the omega-1 receptors, it helps with sleep, but it doesn't make the muscles too relaxed because it doesn't work on the omega-2 receptors so much. Do you know why this is good?
This is better for elder people. Many elder people have trouble sleeping, but if the medicine works too much on the omega-2 receptors, their muscles can get too relaxed and they might feel dizzy or fall when they try to get up. If the benzodiazepine works more on the omega-1 receptors, it reduces the chance of them feeling dizzy or falling.
Let's do a quick quiz. What medications work on GABA systems?
Benzodiazepines, non-benzodiazepines, and barbiturates that help GABA work better.
Correct. Barbiturates increase the duration of chloride channel opening. Benzodiazepines increase the frequency of chloride channel opening. Now, let's talk about melatonin agonists. Do you know what melatonin is?
Melatonin is released from your brain when it gets dark at night. Melatonin tells your brain it's time to sleep. Melatonin is made by the pineal gland and exerts its effects by binding to melatonin receptors. These receptors are G-protein-coupled receptors located in the brain and retina. When melatonin binds to these receptors, it is believed to help guide you to sleep. Interestingly, melatonin receptors are present in various organs, including the heart and intestines, and ongoing research is exploring how melatonin functions in these organs.
This is why artificially created melatonin, known as melatonin agonists, can be used to help guide you to sleep. Let's do a quick quiz. Where is melatonin produced in the body? What are melatonin agonists? Finally, let's talk about orexin. Do you know what orexin does?
Yes. Orexin, also known as hypocretin, is a neuropeptide that helps your body stay awake. That means if we block the orexin-orexin receptor pathway, we might be able to induce sleep.
Exactly. The neuropeptides orexin-A and orexin-B bind to the orexin receptor 1 or orexin receptor 2, helping our body stay awake. So, if we use orexin receptor antagonists, they bind to the receptors instead, so orexin A and B can't bind to their receptors. This weakens the wakefulness signals and makes us feel sleepy. Let's do a quick quiz. What is the primary function of orexin? What happens if we block the orexin-orexin receptor pathway?
Did you grasp the rough mechanisms of the currently used sleeping pills? Subscribe for more insights on how medications work.